What's up, y'all? It's me, Tim, and welcome back to Animal Crossing New Horizons. Let's dive in here. Hello, everyone. This is Tom Nook. It is 6:06 a.m. this happy Saturday, March 21st, 2020. Now for today's news. As of this very day, a brilliant fellow by the name of Blathers will be joining us on Azeroth. Blathers has a keen interest in biology, past and present, and he's here to study Azeroth. I sincerely hope everyone lends their cooperation. Inquisitive residents should stop by his tent for details. That's all for me. Time for you all to get out and enjoy your day. Yes, yes. Okay, guys. Well, this is officially day two for me on Animal Crossing New Horizons. I am so excited. I got mail. I can't see it, but I hear it. From Rocket and Layman. That was a super... It was super awesome to send a gift with your card. Mega wow. Think you're the gift-giving master? Well, two can play at this game. And don't you dare send this back. Yeah, I totally did that. They're funny. Thanks, Rocket. We'll look at your awesome gift. Two stone abs, Tim. Thank you so much for the nice letter and the welcome gift. You're the biggest and buffest surprise of this island so far. I've got you a little something in return. Yours in soreness, Lemon. Oh, man, these cats, they are hilarious. And neither one of them is actually a cat. So, man, I forgot to enter in my codes that I got for my pre-order. I will have to have that up for this next episode. I promise I will. I hope, if I remember. Okay, we are officially pretty much running out of room inside our house. So I have a princess tunic. Let's see what that looks like. I want to see it. Oh, I look super awesome. Do I have the princess tights? I have a kung fu tee. I like the prince. No. I like that. I mean, yes, that is certainly me. I have a cape. I like it. I look ridiculous. I'm in a pith helmet and medieval prince's wear. Okay, now I do have some things to give to Blathers. If he is indeed here, I have things to give him. Oh, man. It'll clear up a little bit of room in my inventory of my floor, which... off camera, I decided to just put everything out in here because I was still going around, you know, fishing and stuff and, you know, things of that nature. And I was so... I didn't mean to pick you up. Clay, you can go back to your home, which is the floor. So, let's pick up this. I think one's a pill bug and one... I'm not even sure. I was so disappointed about this toolbox. It broke my heart. We're not going to worry about it, though. We're going to keep moving on. Paid a fortune for that thing, too. Oh, excuse me. I didn't mean to hiccup. Yeah, I paid a fortune for that thing, too. Oh, hey, it's Lemon. Hey, buddy. Looking built, Chips. What's up? Let's talk. I was kind of hoping life on the island would be a more of a survivalist challenge thing. Like, I thought there'd be big, scary dinosaurs and exploding volcanoes and typhoons every other Tuesday. I'm glad you're wrong, because, dude, now the dinosaur thing would be pretty cool. Just as long as they were, you know, not carnivorous. Hello, Blathers. Hoo-hoo, a pleasure to meet you. My name is Blathers. I'm exceedingly interested in the ecosystem of this island. Thus, I have come to conduct research, if you will. Could it be that you are the... You are Tim, the personage who chose the location for this tent? That's me. The capture card decided to fail, so a splendid job indeed. Thanks to you, I was able to alight on this island with nary a ruffled feather. Now, regarding the aforementioned research. Truth be told, I am determined to open a museum and henceforth dwell on this island amongst you. So, should you discover a new type of insect or fish, do be so kind as to bring it here. I plan to exhibit these creatures as well as those that you gave Tom Nook in the museum upon its completion. Though, I confess, there is one smallish problem regarding said museum. That is, I lack the number of exhibits needed to secure permission to open a museum proper. Empty display cases will not do, I'm told. Display cases with something to display, now that is another matter. Which is where you come in. What? Allow me to explain. You see, it is not only insects and fish I plan to display in my esteemed institution, but fossils too. Oh. As it happens, there sits a substantial stretch of land beyond the river. Yeah, I know. I would bet my pin feathers this primitive plot is flush with the fossils I require. But the river, you say? I can't just hop over it, you say? Oh, silly you. I have a solution. As audacious as trying to populate an entirely deserted island. Okay, y'all know I've been asking this question. Pardon me, Tim, while I transmit the vital data to your Nook phone. I'm so happy I've finally been across this stinking river. How am I going to be able to do this? Is it going to be like bridge technology? But he said hop over. So what could that infer? There, you see. With wood gathered from Azeroth, one can make a lengthy vaulting pole. Oh, okay. This pole can be used to propel oneself across the river. Up and over you go. Hootie-hoo! I sent DIY schematics for a shovel to dig fossils from the ground as well. Yes, finally! Those are my two biggest questions I've had. Which brings me to my point. Please, Tim, cross the river and seek out these ancient relics. My feathers, I have blathered on far too long. But let me leave you with this. If I am to open the museum, I must acquire more items to exhibit, 15 more to be precise. I fervently hope you will donate your precious finds to the cause. I promise you I will. I have 3 on me now, if y'all will be so patient as to let me donate these. Please let me know that I have items to donate or need assistance. I'm here to help. Woohoo! Make a donation! Marvelous. What would you like to donate? Now, Blathers, I remember from the other games that you do not care too much for bugs. So here you go. Here's a bug. Eek! A pill bug! The horror! The repugnance! Good heavens, I must maintain my composure. I beg your pardon. Bugs, I do detest them. Still, there is much I can tell you about the insect you apprehended, if you insist, that is. Please tell me. Aha, I see. In that case, ahem. Blech. The pill bug. Children delight at the way these beasts roll into balls when poked. But the appeal is utterly lost on me. One look at their leggy undersides. Ugh, ew, how they wriggle. Young pill bugs shed their exoskeletons as they grow, and in doing so, sprout another pair of legs. As if 12 appendages weren't enough. Alarming enough. Yuck, I say yuck. My sincerest thank you for your donation. And though bugs are the bane of my existence, rest assured, the wretched thing will get the best of care here. By the by. Yes, I do. I do. I think I can only do one thing at a time, can I? The wharf roach. Again! Eek! Hey, wharf roach! What a wretched thing. Alas, I am obliged to ask, would you like to learn more about this specimen? Please tell me. I see. In that case, the wharf roach is an omnivore, which is merely a polite way of saying it will eat almost anything. This skittering scavenger and its uncouth appetite help keep beaches clean, it's said. But I dare say their long antenna and bulging eyes turned my stomach unappetizing indeed. Anyhoot, my sincerest thanks for your donation. Okay, we know this line, we've seen this line. Let's go on, we have one last thing to donate. I know this takes forever, but I like to learn about it too. Let's see here. So we're just going to kind of breeze over any dialogue that he's already said, like, you know, 1,000 times. This is undoubtedly a pale chub. Now, might I interest you in a few fascinating facts about your pale chub? Yes, please. Wonderful. I would love nothing more. The pale chub is a river fish with a simple black and silver coloring. Interestingly, the male's coloring becomes more vibrant when he's trying to attract a mate. Though normally plain, these fellows really know how to look stylish when they want to. Perhaps I can learn a thing or two from the pale chub. And there you have it. Fascinating stuff, no? Bravo, and thank you. Once the museum is complete, it shall be displayed with the uttermost dignity. Perfectly perfect. So, we only need 12 more donations. And say I'm eager to accept your continued contributions. And he can tell right away that I had nothing else in my inventory because Blathers is a genius. He's also the wise owl. So, do I still have an axe? Or have I killed my axe yet? So, I'm gonna need woods. I need woods to make my pole vault, right? What? Okay, I got a notification. I has a notification. Let's see what it is. Nook Miles, what did I do? Rough-hewn. Island development. We need lots of materials. So based on how much wood you've chopped from trees, I've done 21 of... Look at this, guys. I have enough money to pay for my house. Or, Miles. No way. Do I get anything for donating? Really? Nothing for donating. Oh, plus, we got... Let's use a... Oh, and I had another red light up there. It doesn't matter right now. Let's come up here and make our pole vault. Should I craft something? Let's craft! Can I make everything here like I could at Tom? Oh, yes, a shovel. I need hardwoods. I need hardwoods. What about this? I need softwoods. Now, I did drop woods, so that's just wood. I need softwood. Okay, so pick that up. Pick that up. Pick that up. I'm bound to be close to breaking my axe. I knew it. I knew it! I need a stone. And I need some of these. And then we'll make... I have to stand here, apparently. I need to craft another axe, please. Ask me why, and I'll tell you. Because I need it. What is this? A stone stool? I had no idea. Craftable. There it is. So we need to make another one. Let's do it, please. Can we speed this process up some? There it is. I made it. I'm all done for now because I don't have the necessary accoutrement. So let's drop this. And... Oh, we could go sell some of this stuff at, you know... Let's drop the stone, too, because I don't think we need it right now. Drop item. Okay, so let's carry on. Nope, that was the wrong button. We were here. I don't know if it timed out like other things on the game sometimes do. So I have a whole other island I can de-weed now. And actually, it gives me significant pleasure in doing so. I find great... comfort in watching it clean up. It makes me happy. I believe I have enough hardwood now. Do I have enough softwood? I think I'm about to get it. I have two softwoods here. That should be enough. Hey, we'll come up here and talk to Rocket while we're here. Hey, Rocket! Perfect fishing weather. Time to catch a few fishies. I hear you. I know you're busy. Okay, so let's see if we can craft some items. Wrong button. So, should I craft something? Yes, let's do it. To it. It's craftable. We have enough hardwood. Craft that sucker. I want a shovel. All right, I made a flimsy shovel. Keep on crafting because now I got to make the vaulting pole. And I have enough for it. Yes. Yes. Let's do it. Oh, I'm so excited. No. I didn't mean to keep crafting. I'm so excited. I hit the wrong button. Okay. I want to drop a few things here just to get rid of it in my inventory. Actually, I'm going to sell these two, so I don't care. Because I want to make sure we have a pretty free inventory when the time comes. So let's come over here and see the Nook people. They said they're open 24 hours a day. I also want to pay off my house. So we're going to do that first. No, we're going to talk to Timmy first. I want to get rid of the crud in my stuff. Of course. I have just a few items. Nothing major, you know. Just stuff. Confirm. Allow me just a moment to run all the numbers. All done. Sure. I'll take it. Now, do you happen to have anything for sale, like, with drawers in it? That I can actually store stuff? Just a smoker and an oil barrel. Don't help me. What is this? For beginners, flimsy axe, watering can, slingshot. So I did buy this package before. Does this actually give me more recipes? Okay, I just didn't know. I didn't know if maybe it gave us more recipes like on a daily basis or something. Ah, Tim, hello. I wish we could turn the camera angle. What would you like to talk to me about? I'm all ears. About my moving fees. I now have enough. Oh, you'd like to pay your moving fees. Very well, you owe 5,000 miles. I'm ready to pay. Thank you so much. Indeed, that is 5,000 miles and not a mile less. With that, your moving fees have been paid in full. This is a happy day for both of us. Yes, yes, your fees. You're free and clear of debt, living on a thriving scenic island. What could be better? Oh, that wasn't actually a rhetorical question. Let me be more specific. How is that tent treating you? It could be better, honestly. Okay, I'm sorry to hear that. But no one ever said that developing an island paradise would be easy. But we don't do things because they're easy, hmm? We do things because they're profitable. Well, if you're growing weary of life in a tent... Yes, I suppose the time is right to discuss the possibility of building custom homes. Now, there are certain challenges to building fabulous homes in a remote location such as this. Challenges that do translate directly into cost, I'm afraid. But with zero interest financing and extremely lax repayment plan, anything is possible. So, Tim, if you ever find yourself interested in a new home, do come and see me. Oh, one more thing to share. We have a miles redemption service for the Nook miles you've collected. When you access the Nook stop, you'll be able to redeem your miles for lots of interesting things. You be sure to check it out sometime. Well, then, I hope you continue to enjoy your getaway package life. We need to talk about this. We need to get a new house. About my home. Oh, Tim. Have you made a decision about home ownership? Ready to move forward into comfort and luxury and possible reading lessons? As fun as living in a tent can be, a house gives you more space and helps you put down roots. Now, building a house means taking out a loan in the amount of 98,000 bells. So what do you think? Ready to build your own home? Sweet home? Yes! Thank you for your business. I'll get construction started right away. So now we're moving to the bell system versus the mileage, I assume, right? By the way, you get to choose from 8 different colors for the roof. Could you please select a roof color from this list? A different color, please. There are 4 other options. Choose these or one of the previous colors. Green. Okay. You'll have a green roof. I'll get that in order for you. Yes, yes. Oh, yes. One more thing. Homeowners get an automatic Nook Mileage Program upgrade. Just give me one moment. There we go. Yes, yes, there we go. I've updated your program membership details, Tim. Now, when you use the Nook Miles app, you'll have access to all the Nook Miles Plus benefits. Nook Miles Plus includes a nifty way to earn additional miles for special circumstances. You'll see the details when you launch the app, so please give it a look when you can. All right, now, because I want to cross the river. Your wonderful new home should be ready tomorrow. Yes! Oh, I'm so excited. Yes, I wish I'd have paid my house off yesterday. Darn it. But I did not know I was that close. I guess if I'd have paid attention, that would have helped. Okay, let's go up here and talk to her. Is she still fishing? You know what? Forget you. So we have... Okay, do we have a shovel? Do we need to have the vaulting pole out? I think we do. So let's launch ourselves. Oh, yes! And you... who has been tempting me. I missed entirely. And you, who has been taunting me. Yes! I dug up a fossil. I'm so excited. And while we're over here, and I have a shovel, I'm going to go ahead and plant right here 1 apple. Plant. So, plant that sucker. We now have the potential of 3 apple trees, which is so awesome. Yes! Another fossil! Now, there used to only be, what, 3 fossils a day? Look at these pretty flowers up here. So is that outside our bounds, or can we get up to these places yet? Don't tell me. We're going to have like, a ladder or something. There's, because there's no... I don't know. I can't tell. All right. Let's search down to the river. Trust me, the next time we get on, these weeds will be gone. I promise you. By next episode, we will have a weed-free place. I'm on a beach over here. So what do we got? We will collect... Oh, there's a pier over here. A pier over here. It just appeared. Before we go, I'll collect all these seashells. I just kind of want to look around, make sure there's no fossils on the beach line. This is a big old piece of rock out here. Look, is that another island? I'm seeing other things in the distance. Looky there. I wonder if that has any potential for us in the future. I just simply don't know. So I'm guessing there's no way for us currently to get up on top of this. Not that I'm aware of, anyways. I do love the music on this game. It is beautiful. Now, I think we're good on... Is that... No, that's not a fossil. There it is. So evidently, there is no feasible way for us to go up top yet. I'm guessing. That's just my thoughts on the whole subject. You're a common butterfly. We have found you once before. We're looking for new stuff. Let's get out our pole vault. That's the wrong pole. That's the right one. And, oh, hold on. Let's get our axe. Ah, I missed. Please don't be up. Please don't be up. I'm not quick enough for it. Okay, so far so good. So we have 3 fossils taking up inventory space and all of our tools. It gets frustrating. I wish we had a means of storage, honestly. But let's get out our pole vault. Let's dash across the river here. I wonder if we'll find any other fossils, because it used to only be 3 a day, like I said, back in the old days. That's a big fishy. But we're not worried about fishies right now. Check this out. Oh, there's a little pond up here. I'm not going to obsess about it, but you know as well as I do, there's going to have to be a way to get up here, right? I hope. Another fossil? I said with glee and excitement and trying to find my shovel. Yes! All right, now we got to figure out. So he needs to get 12 more items for donation. Now, I've already given one of these. A wharf roach. So I don't need to capture another one. It's a big old fishy. So that is part of it, too. We capture hermit crab. How are you, sir? So let's look here. I mean, are we going to catch anything other than a sea bass up here? And I wish there was a quicker way to select your tools. I guess there is. I can just open up the menu. How come you're not casting a line, brother? There we go. It's another sea bass, isn't it? Yep. I didn't want a sea bass, but there it is. So we have a little bitty pond up here. Now, different fish do spawn in still waters. All right, I got this little booger. It's a goldfish? No. It is a goldfish. I get to donate a goldfish. Yes. Okay, so these are all tiger butterflies, right? I can't tell what tool I have. It looks like a tiger butterfly. If it is, I'm gonna let it go because I don't need to have another one. Yeah, it's another tiger. Let's release Senor Tiger. Let's just release. Flutter away, little one. And look at all these trees we have to shake up here too. And I you know, we may do that from time to time on camera. I don't know. I mean, I'd like to find a bee's nest and actually be able to capture some bees. I used to get pretty good at capturing bees on New Leaf. I was really good at it. Aha, coin. Stick. Yes. Let's run. Yes! I caught a wasp. That's got stings. So I can donate a wasp too. Oh man. I got so lucky on that. Freshals. And I apologize for yelling in your ear. There it is. We're going to come back over here and we're going to shake some more trees. Now, since I've already got some weeds, I know if you shake trees and there's weeds down, it will make items disappear. So I've learned that the hard way. So if we just clear out a little spot around trees, just so they have enough room to drop stuff. I've already had weeds in my inventory now as it is. So I'm not going to sit here and clean up an entire area like that. So not like this. We have things that need to go to Blathers. So that's going to be our next stop is Blathers. Okie dokie. There's a stick. We don't need no sticks. There's a stick. Each another stick. Okay, I'm getting a lot of sticks. Ooh, furniture. A retro gas pump? Well, neato mosquito. I really hope there is a way to get up on top of those cliffs. I think that'd be neat. Give you more room to explore. Because now, if that's the case, you're very limited. The maps aren't as big as you would think then. Yes. More bells. Okay. So far, so good. Alright, what's next? Did I shake this tree? No, I did not. Okay. I think I already shook this sucker. Okie dokie. And this tree here. So we do have a few things to, let's see, we do not have enough room for anything else really. Maybe there's a teeny tiny fish here. We haven't caught a teeny tiny ocean fish yet because we have 12 more things that have to go to Blathers, so we have to be on the lookout for things to donate. There we go. There we go. I found a rock. What the heck? Oh no! I guess that's it for my fishing rod. That puts the kibosh on this fishing journey. Holy moly. Yeah. And there's my pole vault. Okay, let's get rid of these fossils. We've been playing for a little while here. I'm sorry about that. Okay, so let's talk to Senor Blathers. Please let me know if you have items to donate. Yes, yes, okay. Make donation. We have fossils. Okay, here we go. Woohoo! Indeed, there can be no doubt this is a fossil. Incredible, wonderful, remarkable. My institution was impeccable. My intuition was impeccable. I can't read. That's just where that's at. There are fossils on this island. But I digress. Back to the matter at Wing. I must assess your fabulous find. Let me see here. Indeed. Ooh. This is most assuredly a parasaur skull. My feathers, what a fabulous fossil. This parasaur skull would be a sizable step toward opening a museum. I wonder, would you perhaps consider donating? Just listen, dude. If I'm giving it to you, just take it. Okay, those fossils take some serious time. This also applies to the fossils you brought at this time. Only a specialist such as myself can appraise a newly discovered fossil to determine the its proper designation. From now on, do please bring me any fossils of unknown origin you find. Okay, dude, just go. By the way, I wonder if you have anything else to donate. Yes, please. Marvelous. Why? Are these all the same thing? There's no way. Goldfish. A few fascinating facts about your goldfish. Yes, please. Wonderful. I would love nothing more. Goldfish are so cute and delicate, but do you know how big they can get? Why, they can grow up to a foot in length. Well, sometimes. The size of the tank they're kept in tends to restrict their growth. And just how big will this goldfish get in our large museum tank? I look forward to finding out. And there you have it. Fascinating stuff. Nope. Bravo. Thank you. Once the museum is complete, it shall be displayed with the utmost dignity. And maybe I wasn't reading that right. Are they going to be donating the fossils only once the museum's complete? I don't know. I wonder if you considered anything else. Yes. I got something here. So this is just donation screen, so maybe there's an assess screen. Eek, a wasp! What a wretched thing. Alas, I am obligated to ask, would you like to learn more about this specimen? Please. Ah, I see. In that case, who? Allow me to share a fact with you. Wasps are sometimes called meat bees because they eat meat. Meat of almost any sort, really? Surely you've seen what a menace they can make themselves at picnics. 'Tis hardly the worst of it. What? Aggressive predators with venomous stingers, wasps not only hunt and eat other insects, they paralyze their prey, then drag their victims home alive, leaving them in there for their larvae to feed upon. That is disgusting. Suddenly a simple sting seems quite tolerable. Anywho, my sincerest thanks for your donation. And the bugs are the bane of my existence. Okay, we know. We just need not more donations? Needless to say, I'm eager to accept. Okay, perfect. So, can you not assess them? Assess fossils. There we go. Okay, we have these three to go. We can do all... Oh, yes! We can do them all at one time. That's so awesome! Ooh, more than one I see. Let's take a closer look, shall we? Okay, these are rare fossils, each and every one, and have not appeared in our collection. I say, you have quite a knack for finding valuable fossils. I'm terribly jealous. I only hope I can convince you to donate these and help expand our little museum. In the meantime, I shall return them to you. Oh, so they won't let me do them all in one mass. Duty. Make donations. Iguanodono torso? I don't even know if I said that right. Who could it be? It is an iguanodono torso. I know I'm not reading that right. I never thought I'd lay eyes upon such a well-preserved that thing. Dear me, might I give a short presentation on the topic? Please. Wonderful. Just fascinating stuff, I assure you. Now, where to begin? That graceful ballerina of the... Yeah, okay. Crustaceous. I guess that's what that word is. I just don't know how to read. When I say it was graceful, I mean by... the rather low bar set by other large herbivores. Apparently, it would be nimble. It would nimbly dodge and attack the predators and fight back with its thumb claws. It could even walk on two legs when it wanted to. Truly, was the most elegant of the life of dinosaurs. Okay. Anywho, take my donation. The fossils just, they take so long to explain. I might skip their explanations, honestly, and just read it on the placard. Good gosh. Okay, so here we go. Could it be a diplo pelvis? Never thought I'd lay on such a well-preserved diplo. Short-term... okay. Give it to me. Wonderful. Just fascinating stuff, I assure you. Good old diplodocus. I said that right. What would we do without you? This stout fellow embodied all the best in dinosaurs. Their sturdy legs, magnificent tail, and above all, the extraordinary neck. Did you know that its center of gravity was such that sitting up on its hind legs was probably easy? What's more, paired with its long neck and ability to greatly increase its reach for eating plants. That thing probably grew its entire life, having no adult size. Would that we were all so gifted. Okay. Let's move on. We got one more to go. One more to go! I got something, dang it. The Iguanodono skull. Could it be? It is. An Iguanodon skull. Well preserved. It is well preserved. Okay, hit me with it. Wonderful. 'Tis fascinating stuff, I assure you. Now, where to begin? That graceful ballerina. Yep, we've heard this. We have heard this. We've heard this! So, when you donate one part... Okay, so next time I'll know. When you've already donated one... 6 to go! Can you believe it? Okay, we are so close to getting this museum open. Okay, I found a few things here. I know I'm tacking on a little bit to this video. I found a guy. His name's Gulliver. He's on the beach. I woke him up. I did this between recording here. I've also got enough things to donate to give to the bird to go ahead and get us... do these communication parts stack? They do stack. I've been over here working really hard. I have enough things to donate to get the museum open. So I thought we'd go ahead and just record that. I've already actually donated this little guy here. It's a paper kite butterfly. Beautiful, isn't it? Do I read it, fly it, or spread it on toast? I like that one. So, what we need to do now, we need to find 5 communication parts to get his phone working. Poor old Gulliver. If y'all remember him from New Leaf or anything, he falls overboard all the time, the poor guy. We're going to help him get back to his shipmates. I was just here playing around and just decided I need to tack this on to today's video. That way we can get a complete day. And I missed. You gonna squirt again, you little turd? Or can we dig up? Yes! That should be 5 communication parts, correct? Let's look. That is 5. That's all he needed to jam back in his telephone communication device. So now we need to get our pole equipped and we are going to launch our... Hey, by the way, I also de-weeded the entire joint, if you look. It's de-weeded from top to bottom. I can't stand seeing that clutter. Now, I haven't gotten any type of notification that all is clear. Because I'm not sure. I still think we're going to be able to get up there at some point in time. That's my personal belief, and I'm going to hold fast to it until I'm so sadly disappointed. And I weep in my Cheerios. So here we go. Let's go and look. I also found a bag of gold. I'm just trying to show y'all everything. I found a bag of gold here in glowing gold hole, and I reburied it, and it popped up. I think it's going to make a money tree. I'm not so certain, but maybe. So let's come over here. Let's see Gulliver first. We're going to see this old boy off. Coming. Where's he at? Here he is. Isn't he so cute? Look at this guy. He is just adorable, honestly. Hey, did you find him? I did. I got him right here. Oh, that's them. Those are definitely my communicator parts. Come here, you little troublemakers. Yes, he's so happy. All right, the pieces are crammed back in there. Let's see if this thing can send a message. So he's trying to recontact the ship. Ahoy there, crew. It's me, your butter and a nutter from a nutter rudder. So listen, it happened again. Can you swing by to pick me up? Sending my coordinates now. Gulliver, over and out. There, that should do it. So you're the best. Thanks for all your help. I promise to return the favor. Be sure to check your mail in a few days. I'm going to send you something that'll knock the flippers off you. Knock your flippers off. You know what? I just put that in my own order. I think mine was better. Just make sure you put some flippers on before you open it, okay? I'm saved. Nothing to do now but pace back and forth for the next few hours. I better get started. I love Gulliver. He's so cute. So what do we have here? Nook Miles. So is this for helping Gulliver? What we got here? Where's it at? There it is. Gulliver's Travails? I don't even know. When you come across someone in trouble on the beach, you help them, setting a fine example for all the island residents. Such kindness will surely find its way back to you. So we've helped him one time. There we go. Perfect. Alright, on to see, what's his name? Blathers and Blatherskite. That's right. Now, does anybody ever watch DuckTales? Because that's what the guy on there always said was Blather and Blatherskite. Or am I the only one that remembers that? You know, I am a child of the 80s. What can I say? Hello, Senor Blather. Please let me know if you have items to donate. Yes, I do. So I don't have any fossils. Marvelous! I'd like to donate this little booger here, the tiger beetle. Yeah, I know. Freak out on me. Eek! Tiger beetle! What a wretched thing! Alas, I'm obliged to ask, would you like to learn more about this specimen? In fact, I would. I see. In that case, the tiger beetle is extremely fleet of foot, though it runs in a rather peculiar way. That is, it sprints, then stops, then sprints again, using these speedy maneuvers to run down its prey. You see, the tiger beetle, like a real tiger, is a powerful predator. The mere thought of it giving chase gives me the willies. Tigers are terrifying at any size. Anyhoot, my sincerest thanks for your donation. And though bugs are the bane of my existence, rest assured, the wretched thing will get the best care here. So I have already donated, like, several things. And this is the last two I have to donate. So I'm just trying to keep y'all abreast of the situation. That way we're all on the same page. And look at this beautiful little thing, the sea butterfly. Here we go. It's all yours. Hootie hoo! This must be a sea butterfly. Now, might I interest you in a few fascinating facts about sea butterfly? Yes, you can tell me, please. Wonderful. I would love nothing more. Such mystery. Such grace. Did you know that the sea butterfly's scientific name is the... Oh, crud. There we go. A very rough translation of that is shell body. Indeed, this illustrious creature is related to snails. However, it reminds me much more of an elegant feathered friend. The way it flies through the water with such grace in flying, one shouldn't wonder if it's related to the owl. And there you have it. Fascinating stuff. No, and owls are actually, you know, they're very graceful flyers. Bravo and thank you. They're you can't hear them when they take off. I do believe that means... Huzzah! Hooray! We have acquired the number of specimens required. My feathers, I am at a loss for words. Never would I have imagined we could reach our donation goal on this, my very first day on the island. Man, I don't play. I quit school when they started recess, Jack. So let's go for it. The generosity that made this possible. The passion. I am humbled by the spirit of Azeroth. Or this one guy in particular. Me. Now, we can substitute our application to build... I don't know why I said that. I can't read. Now we can submit our application to build a proper museum. Oh my, I must make haste and prepare for the museum opening. There's so much to do. Hootie hoo. Thank you so very much, Tim. Can I also donate this last thing? Museum construction is about to begin. Thus I can... Oh, you kidding me. However, requests for fossil appraisal are still most welcome. I'm fine then. Duty. I can't offer much in the way of hospitality, but do make yourself comfortable. You know, Blathers, I hope you have a fantastic day. So now that we have that opened up, we've helped out Gulliver, we've opened up the museum. I mean, we are set for an awesome day tomorrow. We also get a new house tomorrow. I'm so excited. All right, guys, well, that's going to wrap it up for this episode. Listen, if you like the video, hit the like button below. Subscribe if you have not. And I hope you have a great day.